Hello, this is the TradeSite US Stocks Futures and Forex Market Preview for the week beginning Sunday, June 26, ending Friday, the 1st of July, halfway through the year. Wow, here's a look at the dollar index daily chart. Didn't do anything this last week. Super boring, obviously, for 5 days. Let's look at the major pairs. Here's the euro dollar, also dead flat. Here's the pound dollar, also dead flat. I mean, this was really one of the most boring weeks of Forex we've seen in quite a while. Aussie dollar, also not much there. Euro yen, hanging near the highs. It looks like it could be, look, that's a high range base cup and handle kind of. A breakout there could be really interesting on the euro yen. Let's look at that. That could be a money maker. Pound yen, even a bigger cup and handle. Looks interesting. Pound Swiss is what it is. And the New Zealand dollar pair. Not much there. Now, if we look at the intra-week action, like I said, not a very exciting week. So here's, you know, 30-minute candle, so you can see the whole week. High to low for the whole week, 130 pips on the euro dollar. That's usually a day's activity, not a week's activity. Pound dollar, 160. That's also pretty poor. I'm not going to go through the rest because it's just not good. I don't know what to tell you, but this is, you know, we enter summer doldrums usually for Forex, and this is just not that exciting of a time. All right, here's a look at the ES front month futures contract. This is the daily chart of the broad market in futures form. And as you can see, we had the 13 buy signal back in May, bounced a little bit, then fell, swept the lows. But look at how we held the risk line perfectly. This is what's so interesting. Remember, this is the most perfect way to look at the market. Nobody cares about the Dow. The S&P cash can be interesting, but at the end of the day, it's the ES front month futures contract. The futures are the most precise way to look at the market. So it's interesting that we held this so perfectly and rallied. So for the week, you know, up for the week, off the risk line. There were some gaps. I'll show you that in a minute. But let's go through the daily charts. S&P cash, like now you can see some of the gaps a little bit. Up 116 to 39.11. The NASDAQ 100 up 408 points. A lot of gaps in the NASDAQ lately, by the way. It makes it really hard to trade, by the way. Two things we hate are dead sideways action. Like, so back to the NASDAQ. Remember that block back at the end of May, the beginning of June? You can see here was like 9 days in a horrible range. That's hard to trade. Gaps are also hard to trade, and we've had a lot of that lately too. So not ideal. But you know, you do what you do. SOX up 115 points. Again, 13 buy signal there. Bounced off the risk line. Biotechs are up 64.96. The Russell 2000 is up 54 points. Crude oil is down 95 cents. Gold is up $5.70. Advanced decline ratio on the NASDAQ is plus 1247. I'm sorry. No, it's not. Plus 981 on Friday. On the New York, it's plus 1925. So it is what it is there. In terms of the volume, we had 9.4 billion. That's the rebalance. And so that's the big heavy day, but it's really not that useful of a volume measure because of the rebounds. Of VIX down $1.82. This thing never got to 40, so just watch out. I don't typically think markets bottom until it does, so whatever. Trend closes at 1.32, puts the 10-day up at 1.46, so we're not going to get a signal there. Apple's up $3.39. Amazon's up $4.02. Meta's up $11.41. Google's up 114.66. Goldman Sachs is up 16.58. That's a big move for Goldman, by the way, but again, just after being clobbered. Netflix up $9.14. This is a big day for a lot of the bigger stocks finally getting a little bit of a comeback, but they've all been hammered so badly. Peloton's sitting at 11. Up 50 cents, this thing, oof, call it a zombie stock, right? Tesla, TLT, the 20-year bond ETF, down $1.58. So bonds down, rates up again. Tesla down, up 31.91 to 737.12. Zoom's up $4.97. This thing seems to be coming out of the mix, and the VIX closes, the VXX closes down 28 cents. Bitcoin's still doing whatever it does, not much there. And that's it. Here's the Dow. Gained 823 points. Nice rebound again on the Dow, but we don't typically care about that so much. All right, in terms of 5 minute, actually the ES intraday, and let's go to 10 minute candles. So, you know, again, Monday was a holiday, Juneteenth. So you can see last Friday, way off to the left, You got the weird day Monday because they opened the futures market with no volume. And then that was a little gap up. But then Tuesday, we really gapped up. So the gap from Friday to Tuesday was a big gap, pushed a little higher, then dead flat. Gap down Wednesday, filled the gap, and went a little higher. But then that was all in the first hour. And then the rest of the day is a waste of time, closed dead flat. Thursday, small gap up, filled the gap. Late in the day, we're kind of even, drifted up a little bit. And then Friday, gap up, pushed higher, and then dead flat. I mean, dead flat into the last candle. That last candle, by the way, that big white candle, that's after the stock market closed. It's not very interesting. So this is, whatever. A flat, when you look at Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, mostly in the same range, and then Friday, the gap up. Like I said, these gaps keep just hurting us because it just ruins what's going on for us in the markets. In terms of economic data coming out this week, at least here in the U.S., we've got durable goods at 8:30 a.m. on Monday, pending home sales at 10, crude oil inventories. I don't know why it says this. This is weird. Somewhere between Monday to Wednesday. Was the number delayed last week, maybe? On Tuesday, goods trade balance now before the bell, housing price index at 9, consumer confidence at 10, Richmond manufacturing index at 10. We've got GDP at 8:30 on Wednesday. That's the final look, so it's not a big deal. Got Fed members speaking, and then that's not a lot of data. Jump to Thursday, we've got core price index, core PCE price index at 8:30. The weekly initial and continuing jobless claims numbers, personal income and spending. Chicago PMI at 9:45, natty gas at 10:30. And on Friday, we've got the final manufacturing PMI at 9:45, ISM manufacturing PMI at 10. Construction spending at 10, and that's the week. So nothing big, no Fed meeting, none of our big three, no first look at GDP, and we're still a little bit off from earnings. The one thing I would say is this is end of month, end of quarter, end of half year on Thursday. So unfortunately, you're into summer doldrums, and you know Wednesday and Thursday probably slow down for the statement printing, and then you know Friday is the 1st of July. And then don't forget, obviously, Monday is the 4th of July, so the following Monday. So that's a holiday here in the U.S. I'm going to be out of town, so it is what it is. But, yeah, that's what we're looking at is we got probably some slow days Wednesday, Thursday. I wouldn't imagine people stick around Friday for a long weekend to start the second half of the year. Monday's a holiday. So, yeah, whatever we get done Monday and Tuesday, maybe Wednesday this week. After that, I would think not much till next Tuesday or Wednesday. And we shall see. Charts as usual, brought to you by eSignal. If you've not yet taken a trial of our services, feel free to do so. We will help you out for a couple weeks. Have a great trading week.